Let's take a look now at the idea of the general multiplication rule. Okay, given two arbitrary events, A and B, the probability that they both occur, the probability of A and B, is equal to the probability of A given B times the probability of B. Now, we looked at this earlier, and we said in the case that they're independent, it's this probability of A times B, which makes sense because remember under independence, if A and B are independent, the probability of A given B is really the same as just the probability of A. So that reduces to probability of A times probability of B. Now, this comes directly from the definition of conditional probability. Probability of A given B is given to us as the probability of A and B divided by the probability of B. Well, if I multiply both sides by the probability of B, it'll cancel here, and I will get the probability of B times the probability of A given B equals the probability of A and B, and this is, in fact, the same thing as I'm saying up here. So, this is a general multiplication rule. We have the specific case where we know A and B were independent, but if we don't know they're independent, then this is the way you go about it. Now, let's take a look at this real quick and work one out. Suppose I ask for the probability of a sophomore and they work from 10 to 20 hours. And again, if this is empirical data, we should probably put a little hat on the guy. We can, because this is in a table form, we can go directly to the answer, which I'm going to do. But then I'm going to work it out back with a general multiplication rule to show you that it really does work. Because you don't always have data set up in a table like this. Well, here's my sophomores. Here's my 10 to 20s. That means the joint is right there. So the answer is going to be 10 divided by 280. That's the answer. Okay? So now let's work it out and see what we get. According to the general multiplication rule, the probability of, hang on, let me change colors here. The probability of a sophomore and they work from 10 to 20 hours is going to equal the probability of a sophomore given they work 10 to 20 hours times the probability that they worked 10 to 20 hours. Okay? All right, so let's go back to the table and get some information here. See the probability that they worked a sophomore given 10 to 20 hours. Okay, let me clear this off. Given 10 to 20 is right here. Sophomore is right here, so that's 10 out of 50. So that's the probability of a sophomore given 10 to 20 hours. That's 10 divided by 50 times the probability of between 10 and 20 hours. Okay, well, 10 to 20 hours is 50 over 280. So this is 50 times 280. The 50s cancel, and this is 10 out of 280, which I believe is, where is it? I wrote it somewhere. Oh, I erased it. That's what we said it was originally. It was 10 out of 280. You can go back and take a look if you don't believe me. But yeah, it was 10 out of 280. So here it is worked out with the general multiplication rule. And that's really all there is to the general multiplication rule. You just take the conditional probability times the individual probability. This is what we're thinking of as a probability of A and B. And this is a probability of A given B times the probability of B. That's it.